South Africa, as promised, I'm coming to you live from the SANMET 2020 red carpet. And of course, what is synonymous with horse races, but fashion, darling. And we've got one of the leading fashion designers that South Africa has to offer, Mr. Gert-Johan Kutsia and the stunning Rory Sang. How excited are you about all the activities today?
You know what? It is so great to see everybody dressed up, everybody coming together in the name of fashion. Great to see everybody dressed up, everybody coming together in the name of fashion and horses.
I think for me, it's all about, I want to take everything in, especially the fashion.
I wanted to take such a classic silhouette, but just adding a bit of an African touch to it to make something completely new. So it's East meets West. It is just something completely
fashion moment. immune support, remain at your peak all year round with ImmuneZone. Catch your premium live.
Clover Fresh Milk is the number one milk brand in SA, made with love by Clover.
With love by Clover.
Clover Fresh Milk is the number one milk brand in SA. Made with love by Clover.
Support, remain at your peak all year round with ImmuneZone. Looking for immune support? Remain at your peak all year round with ImmuneZone. We are now able to donate 20,000 pairs of Smart Step school shoes to children in need. Celebrate goodness when you buy a crush. Dial the number on the pack for a chance to win your share of cash prizes and school fees. Crush, share the goodness. With your support, we are now able to donate 20,000 pairs of Smart Step school shoes to children in need. Celebrate goodness when you buy a crush. Dial the number on the pack for a chance to win your share of cash prizes and school fees. Crush, share the goodness.
Afternoon Express, made with love by Clover.
Another feel-good production.
okay, one of my
friends with them a lot.
It's a Zulu.
Kind of mirror what you're doing.
Okay.
Yeah. Hey, okay. We're kind of playing with this. It kind of sounds good. I can only imagine how beautiful these sounds were.
Yes, it is.
And that's where it comes in.
Wow.
The kids as well. And build this. What's this one called?
This one is Umakhoyane. You can see it's longer than this one.
Mm.
It's a Zulu bow from KZN.
Oh, I love
yes,
that.
I got taught this one by Uma Bengo, and I made these ones myself.
Okay, we got a little melody happening here. Hey, okay.
But you know, I've had interesting moments in 2020.
Yeah.
You know, so like, Jenny, you're like, Benny, look at how many tags I have. This is the party that Jenny.
So the last time I saw Penny was about a month ago.
Well, not a month ago, maybe like 3 weeks ago.
3 weeks ago.
3 weeks ago at
Shimmer
Beach.
On the stage at Black Coffee.
Black Coffee was playing backstage. We were like, we were the DJ girls.
We were the groupies in the DJ box. Yeah.
2020.
Yeah.
You know, so I got on a flight to go to Kimberley, and then the first lady was in the flight.
Stunning.
I took a selfie
Besties.
With her, and then I was going to MC an event, and then there's this campaign that I'm working on, you know, the same thing with SADC, you know, and with the depression anxiety group. And then I go and I speak and I try.
It was
to start an entertainment company.
Absolutely.
So what is that going to be doing? That's exciting.
Well, it's going to be focused on another big love of mine, which is digital marketing. Obviously, yeah. Guys, we know in our industry, influencers yeah. is the age. That's how things are going. And I think, you know, this was very premature of me because I had this idea way earlier.
Yeah.
But South African... influencer as a pointy heels.
Oh yeah, well, you
conversation right now.
Yeah. The instrument. To play to.
Start. How did, what is.
You know.
Festival and music.
another exhilarating performance. We
So it, you know, what happened to me, how can I correct it?
Yeah.
But that helped me to sort of like knock some sense in my head,
yeah.
You know, to eat well, to see, to appreciate the importance of resting, sleeping,
yeah.
You know, drinking my water, dealing with my emotions, and like really processing things when they happen to me rather than just me keeping it moving. And before you know it, you are in your 40s and you don't know what happened.
Yeah.
You know, so that's
yeah,
that.
And it goes so
it
quickly.
It goes so quickly.
So quickly. That's why you've got to appreciate every moment in life, because it just, it
yeah.
goes like
yeah.
this. Now, your career is just, it's been extraordinary. Where are you at in your career? And I've noticed that you're doing a lot of hosting and a lot of work involving like social impacts. Why is that important to you?
So, again, my career started on a community radio station. So I
yeah.
always tell people that whether I liked it or not, I was I'm a developmental broadcaster. So I started from community radio, went into commercial.
Yeah.
So even if I do entertainment, I approach it from a developmental conversation,
yeah.
the business of entertainment.
Amazing.
You know, artists, the exploitation that they have to deal with. You know, to even little things of like on the playlist on a radio station, how many females are featured versus, you know, when I used to do the top 20, I used
yeah.
to be pedantic with such things to say, how come we have
No, but it's important.
It's very, very important because representation is important.
Yeah.
I think the difference is that now we have the right words to articulate that. So
yeah.
when I was doing it for me, you know, I was doing it because that's what I understood about being a broadcaster.
Yeah.
So I worked with Love Life, you know, when Love Life first launched in the country.
That was such a good campaign.
To do, you know, imagine an AIDS-free generation. So
yeah.
I've always been doing work around development. It's just
yeah.
that I had, you know, it wasn't a case of like now where everybody packages themselves as activists,
yeah.
you know, and then they position themselves to look like about they care about things. So for some of us, it's what we've always been doing. We just didn't
yeah.
have the right phrasing
yeah.
and the right branding word, you know, to
yeah.
use for that. So, and I worked with mental health,
yeah.
You know, for as long as I can remember. I work with South African Depression Anxiety Group right now because those conversations are important.
Totally.
South Africa is a developmental state. And
mm.
if you sit in the space of broadcasting, yes, part of it is for you to brand yourself and build yourself.
Yeah.
But the most important aspect is to inform, educate, entertain, and develop our country.
Yeah.
And I take that seriously.
Yeah, and through doing that, you inspire so many people.
Definitely.
Your foundation, how is that growing from strength to strength?
Slowly but surely.
Yeah.
I mean, I think when I first started in 2013, you know, I wanted to go back to where I grew up in Bushbuck Ridge. I went to schools there. I wanted to do nutrition and sustainable gardening because, and that's why I
so
do.
So important.
Yeah, so very important. Because, you know, again, when I had my experience with postnatal depression, I got to learn about the importance of nutrition.
Yeah.
And then obviously the impact that the mother's health and nutrition has on the child.
Yeah.
So I wanted to understand that deeply. So I work with the Maka Foundation, for example, around mother to child care. They're
yeah.
based in the University of Free State. And then the Grow Great, which is what Dr. Mutsipe is part
love,
of,
love
which is about cutting stunting by 2030. Because
yeah.
27% of South African children are not growing at the level that they're supposed
well,
to grow.
Well, because they're going to school hungry.
Because they're going to school hungry, they're not eating at school, they're
yeah.
not, and there's not enough, you know, food at home.
Yeah.
And pregnant mothers are also not informed about that.
Totally.
The basics of just feeding your children eggs by 6 months, that helps develop their brain. So my foundation is really based on that.
Yeah.
So I went to the school, planted vegetable gardens, and then I realized that the need is so big. So I went to go plant vegetable gardens, then they needed water, then
yeah.
they needed shoes, then they needed a uniform. And then
yeah.
I was like, the
I'll
money that MTN gave me, which
gardens.
Was 100,000, was not enough. And then I was like, okay, what are you gonna do? So now I'm trying
yeah.
to consolidate that and work with other organizations that are already in that space. So I just plug in and use my profile to get the conversation going. So I don't have now to be overwhelmed by giving children eggs because Grow Great
yeah.
has got the eggs.
Yeah.
I go work with them and do that. You know, Maka Foundation has got a program at the University of Free State. So I get what Professor Fenter is doing and that information and disseminate that. And then I do the passion work that I love. I do the same thing with SADC, you know, and with the Depression Anxiety
yeah.
Group. And then I go and I speak and I try and raise funds where I can. I climb mountains, you know, for
I mean,
for
not
girl
all
child.
Heroes wear capes. Some of them just have fabulous
hey,
hair.
I'm wearing a cape from Imprint, can't you see? Because the last time I was here, I was talking about climbing Kilimanjaro for sanitary pads
yeah.
with the Nelson Mandela Foundation.
Yeah.
And in 2020, we were talking about it in 2015 to say, we want to take so many girls up Mount Kilimanjaro. Now it's here. And then I did the work with Global Citizen as well. When
you are
here.
Just amazing. So we're going to have you
Thank
back
you.
On the couch a little bit later. But for now, Katima Zulu tells us all about her really exciting new board game after the break.
Cashier number 4, please. Hi, sir. How are you?
I'm good, ma'am. How are you?
Do you have a Woolworths card or my school card with you?
Yes, I do.
Can I please have it? Oh, sister, did you see me running a promotion on the bread, the brown bread? So you get two brown bread for 100 rand.
Shassy, that's ridiculously expensive, eh?
It's okay. So for all these three items, it's 962 rand. Will you be paying card or cash?
I'll be using a card, ma'am.
All right. Do you want to add some donation for the kids? You know that we are doing some charity work.
Of course, why not?
Right. So your total, sir, is 1,500
rand. Hectic, eh?
Right. All right, please enter your card again. It's saying authentication failed.
My card can't decline, ma'am. It's a black card.
Just hold on 2 seconds.
What's going on with my
Catherine.
Card?
Catherine!
Let me know. What's happening?
The card is saying authentication failed. What must happen?
Ask the customer to try another card.
Let's try one more time. Sorry about that. I think it's our machines. Okay, let's try this card. Right. All right, there you go. Oh. Oh. Thank you so much. I told you it's the machine. Next customer, please. Do you have a Smart Shopper card?
No, I don't have a Smart Shopper card.
Did you know with a Smart Shopper
card? I said...
from doing his job. catch Afternoon Express today live at 5 p.m. on SABC3. We chat to fitness coach Tulega Duze about giving free exercise classes in the township. She also takes us through a full-on fitness demo sporting her very own African athleisure brand. We also meet Mr. Joe and Marcel from the Mzananda Animal Scent Clinic. They talk to us all about their important community work with animals and pets in Khayelitsha. Plus, we make a tasty but super healthy couscous salad in the kitchen, so don't miss out.